Hello everyone. Let me give you an overview of the Fluke True RMS Clamp Meters Model 324. This clamp meter is rated at 300 volts category 4 and 600 volts category 3, which puts it in range of residential and many industrial and commercial applications. It is also rated at a maximum of 400 amperes AC. The jaws appeared to be fully insulated. There are no exposed metallic parts. It has a very good spring tension. The white notch there was originally a blank notch, which I remedied by placing a sliver of white sticker to make it more visible. The instrument is provided with a dedicated backlight, which is easy to access, a switch to a button to switch between AC and DC voltage, and another switch to change between degree Celsius and degree Fahrenheit. The instrument always defaults to degree Celsius from off position. And it just happened that this unit of measurement for temperature is my preferred. The box contains the Type K thermocouple for measuring temperature, TL75 test leads. I've measured the length of these test leads from the elbow to the tip to be 1.38 meters. There is a soft carrying case that can fit both the instrument and the test leads, including the thermocouple. Quick reference guide. Safety information. And the retail box. As I understand it, in some market regions, the retail box came in a Chinese version, but this one is in English. All the documentations that came with the instrument are in English. At the back of the box is a table comparing the three models in the in this series: 323, 324, and 325. Among the three, the model 325 has the capability to measure DC current, as well as some other functions. The 324 is the middle model here, and the I would say the entry level for this series is the model 323. Here is the electrical specifications of the instrument. The resistance range is only up to 4,000 ohms only, and the capacitance measurement of the 324 is up to 100 microfarad only, so that might not be enough for some applications. But the Fluke 324 among the three models has the higher resolution when it comes to AC current, being at 0.01 ampere, so theoretically that's 10 milliamperes. And it's good to know that it can go as low as that, as it would increase the usefulness of the instrument a little bit more. The door at the back of the instrument that houses the two AAA batteries that powers it is held in place by a plastic latch instead of a metallic screw. And it can be opened by a flathead screwdriver. Now, I don't know how durable this plastic latch is, but one advantage of that is that you don't have to worry about lost metallic screws, because it appears to be permanently attached to the door of the battery compartment. And this particular model, if you can see it, it's assembled in Malaysia. By the way, the instrument came with these insulating sleeves for the tips of the test leads, which I removed for this demonstration. Now let's do some simple voltage and current measurements. Now, one thing I noticed when you hold the values on the screen using this button, the instrument will beep every 4 seconds as a reminder. And there is no way to disable that beeping until you release the values again. This battery is already running low. This one is still good to use in one of my flashlights. Because of its safety category ratings and 400 amperes capacity, the Fluke 324 should be most useful for residential and many commercial and industrial applications. It's easy to use and backed by the reliability that Fluke was known for. But note that there are other choices out there that cost less and have more features. But if you chose the Fluke 324 as your first clamp meter, I can say with confidence that you have chosen well. Thanks for watching. Stay safe.